pressure, we completed our lesson 4 children. So let us recapitulate what are the points that we discussed here in the course. So first, what is force? What is force, children? Push or pull action. Push or pull action on a body is called as force. Isn't it? A push or pull action on a body is called as force. After that, how many types of forces are there? There are two types of forces. There are contact force and force at a distance. At a distance, or it is also called as field force. Contact force or field force at a distance or field force. In contact force, how many types of forces are there, children? Muscular force, yes, muscular force and frictional force and normal force and tensional force. Muscular force, the force applied by your body muscles. The force applied by your body muscles is called as muscular force. Then what is frictional force? The opposing force that acts on, which opposes the relative, which opposes the relative motion of bodies. The opposing force that opposes the relative motion of bodies is called as frictional force. What is normal force? The contact force acts at point of contact in perpendicular direction. Here it is very important, children. Perpendicular direction. Then what is the tensional force? The force that is present inside the string or rope. Suppose the contact force that is present inside the string or rope is called as tensional force. Then we are talking about force at a distance. We also discussed about force at a distance. In this we are having magnetic force, electrostatic force and also gravitational force. What is magnetic force? Force of attraction or repulsion. Between force of attraction or repulsion between two magnets or magnet and magnetic material. What is electrostatic force? Force of attraction or repulsion between two charges is called as electrostatic force. What is gravitational force? Force of attraction, only attraction, children, here, between two massive bodies, two big bodies, two massive bodies is called as gravitational force. And we also discussed how to calculate the net force on a free moving body or net force on a body. I told you that when you are calculating the net force, you have to calculate in the horizontal direction, in the vertical direction also. In the horizontal direction, two forces are there. Suppose if two forces are are there. One you have to take as positive, the other you have to take as negative. In the vertical direction, if two forces are there, one you should take as positive and the other should take as negative. So, total net force is equal to horizontal forces plus vertical forces.
Isn't it about?
Now, and what all the changes that force will bring, we discussed even that. Force will bring the change in the direction, the change in the speed, and the space change in the shape of a body, and it also brings the change in the state of the body. 3 S, SQT, that means state, shape, speed and direction. It will bring a change in the direction, the speed, change in the speed and change in the shape and also change in the state also. And we also discussed about pressure. Pressure is equal to force per unit area. I told you force is directly proportional and area is indirectly proportional. And if area is more, pressure will be less. If area is less, pressure will be more. So I told you even some examples also. Your back straps are having more area because of more area, less pressure will be there on your shoulder. And I also told you the cutting objects will be having sharp edges because sharp edges means less area, more pressure. Is it or not? So all these help in giving more pressure so that your work will, you can complete your work easily. So with this, children, we have completed our lesson 4. And children, open your textbooks and go through the lesson and please make a running notes by watching the video. We see the video again and again till you understand the concept. If you have any doubts, you can call me, you can contact me. And please make your running notes, and also in new textbook, children, you will be having the do you know questions. Try to answer all the do you know questions. Okay. And at the end of the lesson, you will be having even some points what you have learned. Even read those points and try to answer the questions given in that textbook. Okay. Try to answer the descriptive, that means short and long answers as well as objective also. Okay, if you have any doubts, you can ask me. Not only that, children, in your 10th class, you will be having different books for physics and biology. In the physics textbook, you will be having physics chapters as well as chemistry chapters. Okay, this course is a physics chapter. You should know what is physics and what lessons are under chemistry. This is a physics chapter and this is your first chapter. And if you are thorough with the first chapter, then only you can understand the second chapter, friction. In the force, one type of force I told you about, friction. This will be your second chapter. You will learn more about friction in your second chapter. If you are thorough with this first chapter, then only you will understand the second chapter. So go through the lesson carefully and understand the lesson and write your running notes. Not only the running notes, along with the running notes, along with the points what you understood, along with that, you have to write even do you know questions from your textbook. Okay? Ask me if you have any doubts. Okay, children.